crazy blowout. You can even push the cart. Please don't take my looking forward to Leonard's return as criticism of the job you've been doing in his absence.
I won't.
That criticism will come later in your report card.
Yeah, I didn't stay for the detention. I'm not going to read the report card.
Hello?
The boys talk. Oh my gosh, you weren't supposed to be here till Sunday.
He finished the experiment early, so I thought I'd come home and surprise you.
Oh my gosh, why are we whispering?
I didn't tell Sheldon so we could have a few days alone.
Oh, that's so romantic.
Sure, that's why I did it.
I just cannot believe you're here.
Penny, it's your lucky day. Three of the eggs are clearly not jumbo. Grab your keys.
We're going to go to Manuel Bohorquez, just south of Fort Lauderdale.
Scott, here along Dania Beach, we are seeing dangerous surf, waves up to 10 feet tall, and bands of rain. Officials along this part of South Florida say this is now the time to hunker down and wait for Matthew to pass. The outer bands of Hurricane Matthew pounded South Florida this afternoon with gusty winds and torrential rain. Beaches were closed as the surf became dangerous. Ahead of the storm, business owners raced to board up windows. There were long lines again at gas stations, that is, until they ran out. Also empty, some store shelves. It was a last-minute rush for anyone who hadn't prepared for the storm. Robert McCall lives near Dania Beach and hopes these makeshift sandbags will protect his home from flooding. He's leaving after hearing the governor today.
When he said, this will kill you, not can kill you, it will kill you. That was it. That was it. Time is running out. There are no excuses not to evacuate. Our number one priority is to protect every life.
Governor Rick Scott repeatedly urged people to leave evacuation zones immediately.
We should not be putting people's lives at risk because you made the foolish decision not to evacuate.
Leaving was not an easy process for Gloria Dixon, who runs a group home for 15 residents with cerebral palsy and had to evacuate all of them.
We need this facility not to flood. This is their home. We don't need it to flood. We need things to remain intact.
Another concern as the hurricane churns up the coast is the threat of tornadoes. Florida's governor has activated 3,500 National Guard troops to assist with rescues and recovery. I'm Mark Strassman in Daytona Beach. Local officials worry the predicted 9-foot storm surge will collapse the Main Street Bridge. At some point, the bridges to this barrier island will close to arriving traffic. Most of the 20,000 residents here have left, but not all.
You guys going to hang out, or are you guys going to evacuate?
Michael Chitwood, the Daytona Beach police chief, worries about the holdouts.
And what would you call those people?
You're a fool.
Stupid.
Because this hurricane is unlike any other hurricane we've seen.
By Chitwood's definition, Steve and Judy Lampe are fools. They'll ride out Matthew at home. And both sandbags and aluminum storm shutters will protect them.
The weather's getting worse.
I know.
Any second thoughts?
Once the bridge closes, it's so scary. You know, it's six.
And then you're
stuck.
Three blocks away, Les Thompson decided this morning that staying was foolish. He and his wife, Chris, will head inland to Orlando to stay with their son.
The reality is I don't think we've ever gone through anything like this. Certainly once in a lifetime.
Once the bridge is closed, holdouts will still be allowed to drive off the island, but no one may drive on. Those holdouts have been warned if they call 911 after storm conditions get too dangerous, emergency teams will not respond.
I'm Omar Villafranca on Exuma Island in the Bahamas. Hurricane Matthew tore through this part of the Caribbean last night. The wind and storm surge was so powerful, boats were smashed onto the shore. Hurricane winds over 140 miles per hour ripped the roof off his house in the Bahamas. We felt the wrath of Matthew as the storm hit overnight in Exuma.
Beaches are empty, homes are boarded up, and here on Exuma Island, most of the people are without electricity.
In Haiti, the death toll is over 100 and rising, 2 days after the hurricane hit the island nation as a Category 4. In Jeremie, 145-mile-per-hour winds decimated homes, while floodwaters swept away roads and bridges. The widespread damage prompted the Haitian government to suspend Sunday's presidential election. Back in the Bahamas, crews immediately started clearing debris from the roads at daylight. Magnolia Morley rode out the storm in the motel she managed.
We figure that we're blessed, that the eye passed to the south of us, and we did not get more intense conditions than we did.
Cleaning up the debris will take several days. Thousands of people in the Bahamas are still without power, but many know the storm could have been much worse. Omar Vizcanca, CBS News, Exuma Island, the Bahamas.
Now let's go to Eric Fisher, chief meteorologist at our Boston station, WBZ. Eric, where's this headed?
Scott, unfortunately, we have spent the day watching Matthew regain strength yet again. It is back to a Category 4 hurricane. You can see those spiral bands as it moves through the Bahamas and starts to make its trek toward the state of Florida. The inner eyewall right over Freeport on Grand Bahama. Some very destructive winds expected there. And it will start to move toward the state of Florida as we head into the overnight hours. So hurricane warnings are up from just north of Miami all the way up the coastline. That's a big factor in this storm, the fact that they go all the way up through the coast of South Carolina. And here's a look at the timeline. You see that center as it works its way toward the coast. It may move right along it, just off or just on, but the bottom line is the same. Very destructive winds moving ashore, and since we have these powerful winds, a big storm surge. If you're in an evacuation zone, heed those warnings. Wind is one thing. It is destructive in its own right, but storm surge is the number one killer. Looking out for your safety, listen to those warnings. Storm continues to track right along the coast as it heads up through South and North Carolina, inundating it with very heavy rainfall, and that's one thing to watch as we head toward the weekend. Parts of eastern South and North Carolina have had 10 to 15 inches of rain in the past month. When you add this much rain on top of it, Scott, we could have a very significant flood event unfolding.
Eric Fisher, WBZ. Eric, thanks very much. Most everything we know about Hurricane Matthew comes from the forecasters at the National Hurricane Center in Miami. Earlier today, we spoke to the director, meteorologist Rick Nabb.
I can't remember a hurricane on a track like this. I can either one that has already impacted Haiti and eastern Cuba and is impacting the Bahamas, so many different land areas.
It seems, though, with this track right up the coastline, that if the eye of the storm moves a little bit west, you could take in millions more people very easily.
Well, slight differences in the track of the hurricane could make a huge difference in terms of the magnitude of the impacts for particular locations. Even if the center of circulation stays just offshore, it's easy for the hurricane to bring hurricane-force winds onto the coast, even bring strong winds well inland. Every hurricane has its own DNA, its own characteristics. Matthew's going to write its own story, and I think folks in Florida, Georgia, and South Carolina could end up experiencing wind, water, or both.
What kills most people in a hurricane?
We know that historically, last several decades, with landfall in U.S. tropical systems, 9 out of 10 people who have died as a result of water. The wind can be damaging and deadly too. All the hazards are in play in extremely dangerous situations.
You have enormous experience and history at this, but I wonder, is there anything about this storm that has surprised you?
What has surprised me is how the scenario has set up such that so many people are in harm's way. It's amazing how sometimes hurricanes seek out the worst possible paths in many ways and affect so many people, but that's the reality we're faced with. There's no denying it now. This is a serious threat to several states, Florida up through Georgia and South Carolina. The time is now to act. You don't want to just hope the problem away.
Dr. Rick Nabb, the director of the National Hurricane Center. Up the Atlantic coast, folks who live in Georgia and South Carolina are clearing out of Matthew's path. Harold is on.
The Hunters have called this coastal Georgia community home for 40 years, but today they're leaving it all behind. The Waters family is doing the same.
I grabbed the boys' baby books. I grabbed a wedding album that a girlfriend of mine made us, and a couple important papers, and we're out here.
Here During a storm surge of 10 to 12 feet, 15 inches of rain, and hurricane-force winds, Georgia joined South Carolina today in ordering mandatory evacuations for people on the coast. It also reversed 125 miles of eastbound lanes on Interstate 16 to accommodate those leaving. South Carolina did the same on I-26 as businesses in Charleston boarded up. Both states have deployed the National Guard and opened shelters for those with nowhere to run. We caught up with the mayor of Tybee Island, Jason Bilterman, just before he evacuated.
You can replace your home, you can replace community buildings, but you cannot replace a human life.
The mayor fears the shallow coastal shelf behind me could spell disaster if Matthew pushes up a sizable storm surge as it is expected to do. He also tells me the last time a hurricane followed this exact track and gained strength, Scott, it obliterated this entire island.
Thanks. Well, the world's largest cruise ship ports are closed. Some of those ships are riding out the storm at sea. And major airports in Florida, of course, have shut down. Here's our transportation correspondent, Chris Van Vliet.
The last flight out of Fort Lauderdale left mid-afternoon, leaving workers little time to make final preparations for the looming storm. In West Palm Beach, the check-in kiosks were wrapped in plastic. Judy Balin managed to get a flight to Washington today.
We were the last flight out. We were desperate, but we were the last flight out.
Airports in Miami, Fort Lauderdale, West Palm Beach, and Orlando are all essentially closing, and others could be affected as the storm moves north. More than 3,785 flights through Saturday have already been canceled. George Hobica tracks the airline industry.
Not only do they not want the planes to be stuck in the path of the storm, but they don't want them to be damaged. There are instances where planes actually get tipped over in a very strong wind, so they're going to be moving the planes to a safe harbor.
Amtrak has also halted service in the southeast through at least Saturday. In Orlando, Disney World will be closed at least through Friday, just the fourth shutdown in the park's history.
The airlines are offering waivers so you can make changes or get a refund without having to pay a fee. Scott, the airlines are hoping to slowly begin service as early as tomorrow afternoon, but it could take a couple of days to get things back to normal. And, of course, all of that depends on what kind of damage Matthew brings.
Chris Van Vliet, thanks. Our team will be back with the latest on the hurricane later in the broadcast, but right now let's go to Anthony Mason in New York with more of the day's news. Anthony?
Thanks, Scott. Still ahead on the CBS Evening News, how fast that New Jersey commuter train was going before it crashed last week. And up next, the presidential candidates prepare for a Sunday showdown.
Approaching Medicare eligibility? Don't put off checking out your options until 65. Now is a good time to get the ball rolling. Consider an AARP Medicare Supplement Insurance Plan insured by United Healthcare Insurance Company. Like any of these types of plans, it could help you with out-of-pocket medical costs. Call now and request your free decision guide and explore the range of AARP Medicare Supplement Plans. Start gathering the information you need to roll into 65 with confidence.
Classic, cage-free, and organic.
Old washboard and ruts. Well, for lots of folks that live in the country, this is a normal ride. But it doesn't have to be this way. Not when you own a DR power grader, now available at a new low price. Tow the power grader behind your riding mower, utility tractor, or ATV. With each pass, the power grader loosens, redistributes, and levels surface materials. Potholes and ruts are filled in, washboard is smoothed out, and your resurfaced driveway is ready to roll.
Call 1-800-708-5310 for your free buyer's guide and DVD. You'll learn how you can own a DR power grader for as little as $899.99. Free shipping is now in effect, and with our one-year trial, your satisfaction is guaranteed. Call 1-800-708-5310. Online at drpowergrader.com.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or states, this may be the most important phone call you'll ever make.
I owed $87,000 in taxes. But listen.
Your tax problem is settled. You only owe $3,500.
What a great message.
I owed $11,000 on my taxes. But now...
Good grind,
Congratulations. You only owe $2,068.
How's that sound?
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state, then you owe it to yourself to call this number or go to tax10000.com. Even if you are already at the point where you're struggling with levies and garnishments, let our experts help guide you through the process of negotiating a tax settlement.
We owe the IRS $48,000.
But check out what we actually pay.
Are you sitting down? You only owe $3,471.
Call 800-619-7831 or go to tax10000.com. That's 800-619-7831.
Hey, JJ, I just set the table. What you doing?
I'm cleaning the table.
We didn't eat yet.
I know that, but we gotta make believe like we did. See, those people gonna be here buying them underwear pretty soon, and we gotta get more out of here as soon as possible.
JJ, she's gonna catch on. You just know she is.
I know she ain't, Michael. We told her we ate already. Someone cooked the meal, and it was great.
Then she'll know we're not.
JJ, you think we want to spread the word about the underwear?
Are you kidding, Malona? The galloping gossip of the ghetto? Boy, my mouth won't even big, you can hold a garage sale in there.
Well, I don't know what's taking her so long this morning. I don't think this thing's going to work.
Relax, Michael. She's in there getting dressed for church.
Hey, that's great. Going to church always puts her in a good mood.
Yeah.
Well, oh, yeah, mother dear, don't you look lovely this morning? I swear you never stop getting younger.
JJ, if you don't shut up, I swear you're going to stop getting older.
Seeing a recent move to increase campaign ads on the Weather Channel. On Twitter, RNC Chairman Reince Priebus said Clinton was exploiting Hurricane Matthew for political gain and urged her to apologize.
Trump is here in New Hampshire for what amounts to a tune-up town hall in advance of Sunday's showdown with Clinton. Anthony, on Saturday, Trump will be in Wisconsin at an event in the congressional district of Ryan. But it is unclear if Ryan, the host of the event, and Trump will even appear together.
Major Garrett, thanks, Major. CBS News will bring you live coverage of the Clinton-Trump town meeting debate Sunday evening at 9 Eastern Time. Next, the final seconds before a deadly train crash.
Before I had the shooting burn tens of millions of private nursing, these two made sure stuff in high school. Earned the horn from my dad.
Complete.
And the lab needs an extra person in the class.
Somebody asked me. Why not, Mom? Maybe he's never heard you sing.
Amusement park.
cornfield maze, or back alley dogfight. You tell me.
I'm going to work. You can come if you want.
Okay. By the way, you have something on your shirt.
No, no.
Hurts, doesn't it? Yeah, I find myself wondering if anything you've ever told me is true.
I didn't make it back. The ship sank. I'm in hell.
You say you're from New Jersey, but how can I believe you?
Why would anyone claim to be from New Jersey if they weren't?
All right, I'll give you that one.
Hey, I said I was sorry. What else do you want from me?
I want you to admit that what you did was wrong.
Fine. What I did was wrong.
I wish I could believe you.
You know what? I'm not driving you to work because you're incredibly annoying.
You say one thing and do the other, so then you are driving me and you find me a delight.
Stop it.
So keep it up.
Bye.
Hello. So I guess you're really holding up the other four fingers?
Oh, hey, what are you doing here so early?
Driving Sheldon to work.
He's so mad at Leonard, huh?
He's mad at you, too. He says you're the succubus who led his friend astray.
I don't know what succubus is, but it has suck in it, so that can't be good.
Oh, I heard you out here.
Hey, Sheldon.
You don't get a hey. You get a hmm.
Come on, don't be like that. We had so much fun together the last couple of months.
You're right. Which makes your betrayal all the more devastating.
Sheldon.
I let you buy feminine hygiene products with my supermarket club card. Do you have any idea the kind of coupons I'm going to get in the mail now?
Sheldon, your fight's with Leonard. Penny's got nothing to
do. Now, careful, Amy. The friend of my enemy's girlfriend is my enemy.
Really?
Yes. You're either with me or against me.
You want to take the bus to work?
Maybe there's a third option.
FYI, I've had a donut for breakfast, you jerk.
So now we're just waiting for the data from the ship to be crunched, but the numbers look pretty promising.
It's so great. Have you guys proved the existence of unroot radiation? Hey, my eyes are up here.
Howard, Raj, Judas.
You know what? You're a crazy person.
A crazy person with a long memory, and if all goes according to plan, a robot army. Or a mutant army. It depends on how my Kickstarter goes.
I said, stop it. Now listen to me. You two aren't just friends. You're best friends. That's a beautiful thing. And Leonard, you know why he's so mad at you? It's because he missed you. And as his friend, you should be happy. He has love in his life, as I do. This man held my breast the other day, and I love him for it.
A little loud, dude.
So, can we please put aside these petty differences and just be glad we're here together?
Great. I suppose so.
Thank you.
Well, it wasn't anything weird. It was just to see how big they were.
On the next 2.5 Men, what's up with Alan?
If you fly in the morning, you'll like a drink song.
Tonight at 11 on Night TV Baltimore.
Why do Toyota trucks have best-in-class resale value according to Kelley Blue Book? It all starts with the legendary Toyota dependability. All Toyota trucks come with Toyota Care. 2 years of no-cost commitments. Get the most out of your work days and weekends with Toyota trucks. Just ask a friend who drives one. Toyota.
Valley City Furniture presents How to Know When It...
Side effects of numbers.
controversy include constipation, nausea, and abdominal pain. Stay ahead of IBS-D with Viversi.
Democratic Vice Presidential candidate Tim Kaine joins us.
Trump's running mate, Governor Mike Pence. He's here. The presidential candidates dared reporters to fact-check them, and we did.
Back now in West Palm Beach, Florida. This is the cafeteria of Forest Hill High School, one of nearly 50 shelters set up by the Red Cross to accept about 3,000 people who have answered the governor's call to evacuate. Who are these people?
These are people who have been displaced, essentially. They were either mobile homes or vulnerable places. They're heeding the call from the authorities.
Roberto Baltodano has volunteered for the Red Cross since 1992.
The most important thing that we can do is the peace of mind of knowing they're not alone.
Migbalia Espanina came with her 12-year-old daughter, Jasriah. Jasriah told us that she brought the thing she needed the most. Top of her list, her homework. Omar Mazarigos came with his brother, sister, mom, and dad.
Yeah, we live really close to the evacuation zones and to the shore, so we just wanted to come to a little bit more of a safer spot.
And we couldn't help but notice Angelina Velasquez with her little boy, George. He's 6 days old.
How did you start? Because the Red Cross helped me once. August 24th, 1992, Hurricane Andrew. Fed us for 17 days, and so I came to know what the Red Cross does.
And you've been volunteering ever since?
Ever since.
We asked one man in the shelter if he feared losing his home. He told us, if I have my life, I am rich. And that's the CBS Evening News for tonight. For the latest on the storm, go to our streaming news service, CBSN. We'll have a complete wrap-up of the overnight events on CBS This Morning tomorrow. For our team in Florida and all of us at CBS News all around the world, good night.
The WJZ Mobile Weather Lab, packed with state-of-the-art technology. It's first warning weather in your neighborhood. Tracking storms where weather happens. It's WJZ's Mobile Weather Lab, powered by the Baltimore Area Chevy Dealers.
When I changed jobs, I lost my dental insurance.
I lost my dental insurance.
Volunteering at the local rescue center, but she recently had a fall, and I worry because I know she won't slow down. So I went online and found the new Lively Urgent Response device from Great Call. It's completely mobile, and now she takes it everywhere. Oh, it's so reassuring knowing she can get help with just the press of a button.
One touch in any unsafe or uncertain situation, you'll be immediately connected to a highly trained agent who can confirm your location, assess the situation, and get you the help you need.
There's even a free link app that connects my mom's Lively to my smartphone, so I'll be notified right away if something does happen. I'm so happy that my mom can keep doing what she loves, and she's happy too, knowing I don't have to worry. Buy the Lively Urgent Response device at Walmart Pharmacy or Rite Aid and get the first month free.
Exclusively from Great Call.
Learn more at greatcall.com.
That takes you to your happy place.
Nothing but the best.
Or a childhood favorite food.
I think I know what you mean.
That can get you in a nostalgic mood.
I get in a nostalgic mood.
TV conversations.
Count on.
Throwbacks. And news on your favorite classic shows and stars.
Hey, that's great news.
It's all on Antenna 2D's Facebook page. America's number one retro channel Facebook page. Like us at facebook.com/AntennaTV.
Good times.
One out of five Americans can't fill their prescriptions. Why? They can't afford them. The free RX Plus hotline is here to
help. This is an example of speech synthesis.
Free.
We would be more than happy to provide you with this drug for 5 years free of charge.
We got some of our chemotherapeutic drugs free. If you don't ask, you can't get help.
There's more than just free prescriptions. Free dental. Over 15,000 dentists have provided over $300 million in free dental work.
We can't afford to go to the dentist on a regular basis like we did when we were fully employed.
Free electric. 7 million families have received $250 to $600 for their electric bill.
Wow, free electric, that's wonderful.
Medical supplies like back braces, knee braces, and diabetic supplies may be covered too. The free RX Plus hotline has saved callers over $10 million on thousands of prescription medications. Call now. You can even qualify for free brand name prescriptions, along with dental and so much more. If you are over the age of 50 and considering buying an annuity in the next 60 days, I have some important news for you. Don't buy an annuity until you understand the pros and cons of annuities. A free book to help you maximize your retirement income from PBS host and three-time author Josh Melberg has been released. This book reveals little-known truths about annuity strategies in simple-to-understand terms. Grab a pen right now, because we're about to offer you this free book that unlocks the five little-known secrets we believe baby boomers and seniors should know before buying an annuity. Call 800-832-9163 now, and you'll receive a free copy of Josh Melberg's book, Next Gen Annuity Strategies Revealed. As a bonus, we'll also send you the number one mistakes retirees are making with their investments today, and a free DVD on how you can get up to 33% more income in retirement. Call 800-832-9163 to have your free information kit rushed to your door. Again, that's 800-832-9163.
Tonight on Johnny Carson, a good friend of mine and a fine, fine actor, Mr. Roger Moore. Maureen Stapleton. Johnny Carson, tonight 11 Eastern on Antenna TV.
I can't tell you the hassle I had carrying this thing on the bus here today. This lady kept yakking and yakking at me.
About what?
I don't know. When I stood up to find out, she went and took my seat.
That's what I said.
All right.
Chandra, you had it framed so nice. Oh, I'm sure Willona's just going to love it.
Hey, painting without her knowing it was no big problem. Painting when she wasn't talking, now that was the problem.
Well,
we'll
only be here any minute, so hide painting in my room, okay?
Right.
Oh, my, you know... Do you think we did the right thing by inviting Rick? You know, he and Willona have been divorced like 6 years, and you know how Willona feels about it. How about this?
Come on.
Yeah, okay,
now. Do you think you'll sleep with him tonight?
Absolutely not. Look, we're just gonna have dinner and, you know, see how it goes. If he were dying, would you sleep with him?
What?
Assuming he were dying of something that couldn't be sexually transmitted. You know, like a spear wound to the head.
Okay, he is not dying.
How do you know? Are you a doctor?
You can make believe, though. Sometimes Howard and I pretend that his arrhythmia is acting up, that I'm a sexy cardiologist. And the naughty part is, I'm not in his HMO network.
Screw it. I'm not going to make a big deal out of this. It's just dinner.
With a dead man.
Amy, stop it. I'm so nervous.
Relax. You know Leonard's always been crazy about you. It's going to be great.
I know, but we finally got into a place where we can hang out without it being weird. And if something goes wrong, then what?
Guess it'll just be Sheldon and me going on a double date with Howard and Bernadette.
Sure. We'd love that. Change your clothes. We got a lot riding on this.
I want to build a road, but I need wood. Do either of you fellas have wood? I don't understand the laughter. The object of settlers of Catan is to build roads and settlements. To do so requires wood. Now, I have sheep. I need wood.
dealing with?
What are you talking about?
Did you forget what Benny did to you? It took you 2 years and defiling my sister to turn that frown upside down.
Didn't defile your sister. We had a relationship.
I heard you call her brown sugar. In my book, that's defilement.
You want to know my opinion?
Oh, boy, do I.
Sarcasm?
Yeah. Nah.
The reason you're fixating on a good-natured simpleton like Penny is that she's the exact opposite of your first romantic attachment, your brilliant yet intimidating mother.
Where on earth did you get that from?
It's in her book, Needy Baby, Greedy Baby.
That doesn't make it true.
It's called nonfiction for a reason, Leonard.
See you later.
Where were we? Oh, yes. Does anyone have any wood? Come on. I just want wood. Why are you making it so hard?
So, do they have a name for a first date with someone you used to go out with?
Oh, that's a good question. About awkward?
Right. How about if we pretend we're actually on our first date? See how that goes.
Okay.
So, Polly, tell me about yourself.
It's Penny.
Oh, sorry. Yeah. Awkward.
Okay, let's see. I'm from Nebraska, and ever since I was a little girl, I dreamed of moving to LA and becoming a movie star. Anyway, after 4 years of acting lessons and waiting tables, I've done a hemorrhoid commercial and a production of Anne Frank above a bowling alley. So, you know, dreams do come true. Your turn.
Let's see. I am an experimental physicist at Caltech. Most of my research is with high-powered lasers. And, oh, I've just gotten a big government grant to see if they can be used to knock out incoming ballistic missiles.
Wow. Can they?
Oh, God, no. The money's pretty good. And I used the equipment to make my own bat signal.
Bat signal? Well, you some kind of nerd?
Not some kind of nerd. I am the king of nerds.
What does that mean?
It means if anyone displeases me, I don't help them set up their printer.
You are so funny.
Good. Remember that when I take my shirt off.
Leonard, this is nice. I'm so glad we did this.
Me too. So what do you think? Are we going to get back together?
Whoa, not so fast.
I'm sorry, what did I say?
Leonard, you know I will always have feelings for you.
Oh, God.
What?
You said always. You'll always have feelings for me.
So?
So, that sounds more like something you'd say if you didn't want a relationship with someone. This isn't working out, but I'll always have feelings for you. I'm sorry I slept with your best friend, but I'll always have feelings for you. Here's the thing, Lisa. I'm into dudes now, but I'll always have feelings for you.
How would you say it?
I have feelings for you.
It's the same thing.
No, it's not. Always made it worse.
You're overthinking this.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. You always overthink.
There you go. Always made it worse.
See, this is where everything goes wrong when we talk.
I don't know how you have a relationship without talking.
Hey, I went out with this guy, TJ, for 8 months. We never talked. To this day, I don't even know what TJ stands for.
Wait, if you guys didn't talk, were you...
Some wood. I'm going to begin the erection of my settlement.
I've got to be doing this on purpose.
Ooh, 8:30. You and Penny decided to go out and paint the town beige.
You're 30 years old and you live with your mother.
I guess it didn't go well.
No, we don't know that. Not to a certainty. All we know is that Leonard is home.
How about now?
Again, enough evidence. For all we know, he's being murdered. Now, back. to our game. So you were in the middle of an erection?
Yeah.
Oh, of course, it's right here in my hand.
Get up, buddy. I'll get it this time. Yeah.
Okay, not too quick. Don't let go until I say so.
I got you. Start strong with the lasting energy of 100% whole grain Quaker oats. And off you go.
What good time.
Ray, wait a minute. Well, Ona, aren't you gonna open it?
Wait a minute.
Hey, I don't know what this is, but, this is the first time you ever gave me anything.
Come on, open it, please.
Okay. So nervous.
Oh, Lola, that's a beautiful locket.
Ray, hey, thank you. It's lovely.
You know, I came this close to getting you a diamond ring. But then I ran out of Cracker Jack box.
Hey, I know you. When you decide to go, you go first class. Oh, listen, maybe I have been wrong. Maybe
a tiger can't change his butt.
Stripes.
Whatever.
Well, Ray, you haven't had your cake yet. Why don't you stay one?
Hooray! I thought you never had.
Hi, I'm Dave Nemeth, television talk show host, and until recently, a hair loss sufferer. That's right, I used to have a bald spot right here on the back of my head. And being seen by millions on TV, it was embarrassing. That's when I turned to Hairpro, the number one customized hair loss solution provider in North America. Today, my bald spot is gone, and I feel 100% more confident.
I'm 52, and I look better now than I did when I was in my 40s.
I love it. I really do. It has changed my outlook on life.
With over 900 experts across North America and backed by 40 years of amazing results, Hair Club provides exclusive technologies and proven solutions for every stage of hair loss.
At Hair Club, we understand what it's like to lose your hair, and we understand what it's like to get it back, and we'd like you to have that experience.
Based on my need for immediate results, Hair Club customized the right solution for me. It's called X-Strands. It's new and only available through Hair Club. I walked in with a bald spot, and that same day, walked out with a full head of hair. Just call or go online now to receive your free information kit and DVD at no obligation. You'll hear more about our full range of solutions, including exclusive non-surgical X-Strands and X-Strands Plus.
Now I look in the mirror, and I just can't believe that's me.
This is my hair, and it feels great, it feels natural, it's growing, it's strong.
I leave my house. I'm not thinking, oh, how does my hair look? I know it looks good.
This was me before going to Hair Club. And this was me.
Are never safe. The sweet and spicy chicken bites box. Chicken bites and sweet and spicy sauce with fries. Also available in classic or buffalo for just $3. Checkers and Rallies. Fast food is not a deal.
The Jerry Springer Show. Weekdays at 4 on MyTV Baltimore.
Closed captioning and other consideration for the Big Bang Theory provided by...
When you ache and haven't slept, you're not you. Tylenol PM relieves pain and helps you fall fast asleep and stay asleep. We give you a night, a better you all day. Tylenol. Dare to blush nude.
The Blush Nudes Palette from Maybelline, New York. Our 12 Shadow Palette is selected to seduce. From risque rose to tempting taupe, Maybelline's The Blush Nudes Palette. Make them blush. Make it happen.
Maybelline, New York.
Well, that was fun.
Yeah, except for when I got the foot cramp.
You hung in there, though.
There's a lot at stake.
So what do you want to do now?
Well, I want to go get my asthma inhaler, but might ruin the moment. Just help me out here. How does a miserable day end in sex?
I don't know. It's complicated.
Well, I'm a pretty smart guy. Right now, my brain has dibs on the blood supply, so I'll give it a go.
Okay, it's just... At the restaurant, when you said you wanted us to be together again, it got very real, very fast, and I panicked.
Why? What are you afraid of?
Well, what if we do go out and I do something stupid and dump you again?
What if I dump you?
Come on, be serious.
Well, how about if we don't think about this as a relationship? It could be more like a new version of software. Penny and Leonard 2.0. We can test it internally, shake out the bugs, and if we both feel it's solid, then we'll roll it out to the public.
So we don't tell people we're back together?
Exactly. You know, we pretend like our date went badly.
Well, we don't really have to pretend.
And we let them think that we decided to just be friends and that everything's cool.
Okay, great. Hey, I just remembered. I still got one of your inhalers.
I can't believe you kept this.
Yeah, I was gonna throw it away, but I just couldn't.
That's so sweet. In 25 to 30 minutes, I'm gonna show you how much this means to me.
Leonard?
Yeah, hi. How's it going?
Can't complain. Thanks for asking. What were you doing out at 3 o'clock in the morning?
What are you doing up?
I was using the bathroom.
Yeah, well,
so was I.
Really? I didn't see you in there.
Obviously, but when I saw that you weren't ours, I went and used another one.
Where?
The gas station across the street.
In your pajamas?
Yes.
Without shoes?
Yes.
On a cold winter's night?
Yes. Yes.
That seems unlikely. Did you bring your asthma inhaler?
Yes, I did.
Well, I guess it's plausible. Hang on a second, mister.
Why?
After you used the facilities at the gas station, did you make a purchase?
What?
It's customary when using the restroom at a retail establishment to make a small purchase. Did you?
No.
No.
Here's $2. Go buy some beef jerky.
I want beef jerky.
It's not about you. It's about a poor immigrant from Pakistan trying to make his way in America by working the graveyard shift at the Colorado Boulevard Chevron. Fine. Needy baby, greedy baby, indeed. Leonard will be here in a moment. He's looking for a different parking space.
Why?
We were next to a car with an "Ask Me About My Grandchildren" bumper sticker, and I was afraid if we ran into them on the way out, I'd be obligated to do so.
I'm disappointed it didn't work with him and Penny.
Me too. Out of deference to them, let's not flaunt our happy relationship.
You have a keen insight into the human heart, Amy Farrah.
We are next to a Subaru with a Gore Lieberman bumper sticker.
Well, I doubt they want to talk about that, so we're fine.
I'm surprised to see you here after it went so badly with Penny.
Well, hey, we're grown-ups. We can still be friends.
Roy, I don't know if I could be friends with Howie if we broke up.
Why not?
He's a very vengeful person.
Really?
With access to weaponized smallpox.
Go with some water? You need menus or you know what you want?
Leonard knows what he wants, but it looks like he's not going to get it from you.
No, that's okay, Bernadette. Sometimes these things just don't work out.
Yeah, it's all good. We'll always have feelings for each other.
Oh, that's nice.
See, she knew it always meant.
Wow, you're like a dog with a bone, aren't you?
I'm just making a point.
It's the point that you don't know when to let something go.
People, please. Before you say something you both regret, I'd like to place my order.
Hang on, Sheldon. You know why we can't be together? Because you always have to be right.
That is not true.
I gotta go with Leonard on this. He is wrong more than anyone I know.
You know, I just realized I'm on a break. I'll get someone else.
Leonard, promise me that when our new waitress comes over, you will not start a complicated on-again, off-again relationship with her, because I'm very, very hungry.
You were being such a jerk at the restaurant.
Well, I was trying to act like we weren't seeing each other. That was the plan, right?
The plan was to tell people we decided to stay friends. That's a little hard to do when you're always being such a tool bag.
Well, I don't have to stand here and take this crap.
The hell do you think you're going?
Isn't sex after fighting kind of what we do now?
Yeah, kind of, yeah.
For you and me ends badly.
It's because you overthink everything.
Lena, are you listening to me?
What? Yeah.
This is a disaster. I distinctly ordered the Leonard Nimoy Mr. Spock cardboard standee. Why would I feel safer with Zachary Quinto at the foot of my bed?
I don't know. He was pretty badass with Heroes.
You're right. I'll give him a shot.
Hang on. Penny, do you have plans for dinner?
Why, you guys going somewhere?
No, I mean just you and me.
Have you thought this through?
Yes, and I think we should go anyway.
No, can't do it. Sorry, Quinto, if you're going back.
You saw exactly what I saw in the sky tonight. Unidentified flying objects. Do you believe in the existence of extraterrestrials?
I'm here just like you to solve this.
The X-Files. Viewer discretion advised.
Tonight at 8 on MyTV Baltimore.
Why have you not yet offered me cupcake?
Oh, sure. Chocolate or vanilla?
Yes.
Next, Two Broke Girls. Tonight at 10 on MyTV Baltimore.
We all want a living room straight out of a movie set.
But what if you don't have movie star money?
Well, you can still have all the style and comfort you want with a surprisingly affordable Urban Attitudes collection from Lazy Boy. Urban Attitudes from Lazy Boy. Live life comfortably.
Toyota's flash savings event with thousands of award-winning Toyotas to choose from, including brand new 17s and amazing closeout deals on remaining 16s. Visit buyatoyota.com for special limited-time flash deals not seen on TV. From low payment leases to 0% APR on select models, and every new Toyota is backed by Toyota Care. 2 years of no-cost maintenance.
As a lawyer, my father's been the best mentor I could ever ask for.
The attorneys of Cohen, Snyder, Eisenberg, and Katzenberg.
Our fathers have over 80 years of combined legal experience, and that is something Brian and I rely on every day.
More importantly, that wealth of knowledge is something our clients benefit from, and that's really what it's all about.
If you've been injured, the lawyers of Cohen, Snyder, Eisenberg, and Katzenberg will fight for the compensation you deserve. Call for a free consultation.
You know, for me, home is where life happens. And with the Magnolia Home Furniture and Accessories line, I really wanted to offer unique, timeless pieces that spoke to many different styles that you would have fun mixing and matching. So when you blend all these styles together, it creates this inspiring space for your family to call home. I'm really excited to share with you my line, Magnolia Home Furniture and Accessories.
Available in stores now at Value City Furniture. We'll shop the entire collection at vcf.com.
2.5 men tackles gay marriage.
Walton, do you take Alan to be your lawfully wedded husband?
I do.
Let me kiss.
Watch 2.5 men.
Tonight at 11 and 11:30 on MyTV Baltimore.
If you and Leonard get back together, Sheldon and I will finally have someone to go on double dates with.
What about me and Howard?
Fine, we can double with you too. So insecure.
Where are you guys going to eat?
Penny?
Do you, Penny, take Leonard to be your lawful wedded husband?
Well, it's a little late for me to start saying no, isn't it? Penny. Hi. Just remember, I've got to stop by the drugstore.
USB port. The USB port that looks suspiciously like a sofa. It's probably the best looking USB port ever and only $7.99. Plug in your devices and binge watch in extreme comfort with my Bobopedic seating. Plus dual power recliners and dual power headrests. Get the USB port that looks suspiciously like a sofa or the one that looks like a console love seat in dark chocolate or light brown. Each only $7.99. Untouchable and only at my Bob's Discount Furniture.
Do you snore or wake up with back pain? Well, the problem could be your mattress. Visit a sleep expert at the best mattress store inside the sofa store. Guaranteed low prices. The best brands. The store you can trust. The best mattress store.
The storm will kill you. Time is running out.
Tonight at 11, facing Hurricane Matthew.
There are no excuses. You need to leave.
Florida locks down as the massive storm approaches, the millions of people affected by its path, and how the White House is responding tonight.
Plus, seeking shelter, 11 News shows how a local humane society is helping dozens of animals impacted by the storm.
That's live, local, late-breaking. Tonight at 11 on 11 News. Tonight's primetime on WVAL-TV is brought to you by Len the Plumber.
Gabby is in soft lines, Elias grocery, Jonah, you're at the gun counter.
Can I switch with somebody? I don't really believe in guns. I mean, I'm just kind of against selling them, or buying them, or owning them.
You don't have a gun?
No, what do I need a gun for?
Home security? Hunting? I mean, without guns, how are you going to properly start a drag race? Vaya con Dios, amigos!
Without a gun, I do not know how I would stop that raccoon from trying to impregnate my Winnie the Pooh lawn ornament.
Okay, look, I'm not like against weapons as a whole. I fenced in college.
Okay.
What are you doing?
Oh, I'm keeping a list of all the crazy white person stuff you say.
Oh, fencing. That's definitely going on there.
What else is on there?
Oh, it's long. I got wearing boat shoes, BBC America, makes his own trail mix.
Guess who?
Won't fit no matter how hard you try.
Gotham Steel Double Grill. The extra large nonstick cooking service with a grill on one side and a griddle on the other. It's made with Thai Cerama.
So you see how, within an hour of this video, the bitch turned up. Those bitches turned up. The bitch in the green car and the bitch driving that black, that old black BMW around his store tags. See how they jacked the love up, don't you? And within the first couple minutes of the video, the bitches jacked it up real quick when I turned around to face my computer. And of course, you didn't see me turn around to face my computer, but you see how the bitches jacked the levels up real quick.